Hello, I'm Isaac Newton, and today we're going to learn about forces acting on an object by observing its motion. Back in 1687, I developed three laws to describe how an object's motion is affected by force. The first law, which is what we will talk about today, states that an object will remain in its state of rest or constant velocity in a straight line unless acted upon by an unbalanced force. What's that I say? Let's break it down a bit.
If an object, say this eraser, is not moving, then we can come to the conclusion that all the forces acting upon it are equal. There are two forces acting upon the eraser. First is the force of gravity, which is pulling the block down. Second is the force of the ledge on the eraser. And since the eraser is not moving, these two forces are equal or balanced.
Now, for some real-world examples of the first law at work, because I know you're thinking, well, this is really wondrous, Newton, but how does it affect me? Over the next few minutes, I plan to show you just that.
Friction is an example of a force that often acts upon objects. If this air hockey puck is pushed, it will send the puck in the direction in which the force was applied, in this case to the right. However, friction between the puck and the table causes the puck to stop because the forces acting upon the puck are unbalanced. Now, what would happen if we turn this air hockey table on to simulate a frictionless event? As you can see, the puck slid all the way across the table because we have taken away the frictional force applied.
I can ride my bike with no handlebars, no handlebars, no handlebars.
By riding in the Jeep, Barbie is being carried in a constant forward motion due to the force of the Jeep. According to the first law of motion, she will continue to travel in this direction until acted upon by an unbalanced force, or if there is a change in the force that is pushing her forward. When the Jeep wrecks into the rock, it is stopped by the force of the rock in its path. However, Barbie is not attached to the car by seatbelt, so she continues in her forward motion, causing her to go over the hood of the vehicle. When skydiving, several forces are acting upon you so that you remain in a floating state. Take a moment to discuss these forces with your classmates. We'll wait. You're back! Did you get the right answers? Did you think about gravity? Or how about the force from the wind tunnel? Great! Now take a moment to think if the forces acting upon you are different if two people are skydiving. Does the fan have to work harder? See what your classmates think.
Everybody just have a good time. Clap. Party rock is in the house tonight.